Good morning, Prince Logan. It's time to get up. Hello, this is the RPG Chick, Amethyst Lunatari. Welcome to a brand new Let's Play. This is Dragon Slayer, The Legend of Heroes by Nihon Falcom. And just going to say some quick things. I'm getting over a cold, so that's why my voice sounds a little scratchy like this. And I'm playing this game blind for the most part. I've only reached the first city, you know, besides the city we start in. So, really very beginning. And I read all the things, except for the horribly bad voice acting. That will be read for us by, I don't know if they're bad voice actors or just lack direction or good recording equipment. But the voice acting is laughably bad. There is no subtitles. So, you'll have to just listen along. And, yeah, this was released by Nihon Falcom in originally 1989 for the NEC PC-8801 in Japan, and then came out to a whole bunch of different systems, including PCs, different consoles, including PlayStation, but unfortunately, all in Japan, one version in Korea, and the only North American release, the only release in English, is this one for the TurboGrafx CD, released in 1992. Now, for those who don't know, well, the series was originally Dragon Slayer, came out with various different Dragon Slayer games, and then this one came out, Dragon Slayer, The Legend of Heroes. So, the Legend of Heroes series is a spin-off of the Dragon Slayer series, which, Dragon Slayer has fallen off, and now it's The Legend of Heroes. After a few more games after this one, for the, well, only released in English on a PlayStation Portable, they came out with Trails in the Sky, which is part of the Legend of Heroes series you may have heard of, and Trails of Cold Steel and beyond. So, I plan on playing all these games, at least getting to the first Trails in the Sky game. And, yeah, I've heard the world building, the lore, the political intrigue, the very cast of characters, and my voice is, like, dodgy here, is really quite a sight to see. But these first games are pretty basic, yet still, from what I can see, pretty fun. So let's get into it. The Royal Maid is telling Prince Logan that it's time to get up and get morning. Yeah. Beware the voice acting.
A fine morning to you, my lord.
Good morning, Elias.
Ah, my dear Prince Logan. I understand from the gate guards that you're still indulging in slime bashing. I hardly think that such a childish pastime befits one who is destined to inherit the throne in just 2 more months. As I've said time and time again, the future is shaped by knowledge. I'm sure you'll agree that your time would be better spent in study rather than chasing those ghastly green jelly globs. Now, if you'll pardon me for a moment, I'll go and get my book so that we can commence with your studies.
Uh-huh. Now, I just have to wonder, they're saying that fighting slimes is a childish activity? What kind of child runs around and fights slimes? Like, how can that be safe for a young lad? Or that he says he's apparently it's childish and it's below him, so apparently children even younger than him, you know, be more suited to that task than Prince Logan, because he's older. He's going to be a young lord. I don't know. Anyway, Chapter 1, The Uprising. Pretty interesting. There's different chapters. And Exile, that's the place that we're in. That's the town, a city, or that we're in. It's not really, it doesn't really seem like a city. So, we have options. Of course, save, load, system, battle. Auto battle off, auto healing, okay. Attack, spell, healing, spell. Pretty cool. Auto character. I'm not even sure what auto party and auto character is. I'm gonna have to look some of this stuff up. Status. So we had more characters, we could see these status. Stati. Well, we got Logan has a dagger and a tunic. He has these stats. Of course, he has 30 hit points, 5 magic points, no experience points. Oh, and these options. Narration we could turn off, but why would we do that? The voiceovers are so cheesy and fun. Point distribution auto. I'm going to change it to manual. And experience total. This shows us how many total experience we have. If we switch this, it tells us how many experience we have to get to the next level, which we see as 20. The background music is PSG. I'm not sure what that is. Just regular. And this is CD. Now, the CD, from what I understand, this music stays the same, but it changes the battle music and maybe some other music as well. The only downside I hear to this CD music is that when the battle is done and like this kind of music starts playing again, overworld music or what have you, it starts from the beginning as opposed to starting where it left off. So you might not hear the entire, you know, overworld, whatever town music. So I might switch that back and forth. Character speed, fast. Message fast. That will suit our purposes. Okay. And then equip, we can't equip these things. We have torches, detoxin, which is apparently, yeah, that's cures poison. Seeker eye, I'm not completely sure what that is. But I will find out. After I record a couple episodes, I was going to take a peek at the manual. But right now, it's just really basic stuff here. And what else? Trying to quit out. Okay. And then items. Mainly the items we have. Spells. So we have Cure 1. And Detox is apparently anti-poison, like the items we have. Notice we don't even have enough magic points for the cure. I'm guessing that's just a healing spell. We can't even cast it. Not enough magic points. Isn't that sad? Anyway, we can just walk around people by talk to people by bumping into them. We could try to go to bed and, you know, it's not gonna work. Give me a moment, my lord. I'm looking for the scrolls. I couldn't resist. The royal maid says, are you going out? It's a sunny day. Have fun. Smell that yummy stew. Oh boy. Hello, Prince Logan. I'm cooking up a batch of slime stew. Ugh. Really? Can't go out there. Hi. If you plan on going out, make sure you're back by dark. So I'm gonna look around. Talk to everybody. Father Richard, what a smashing day to see you here at the secret temple. It's too bad we're living in such hard times under the terror of cowls, prowlers, and their evil brood. The great seeker's powers seem to be dwindling. Who knows what's next? The great seeker's powers. So can't look at that. Oh. There are slimes out there, beware. Slimes out there, beware. I'm not going out there yet. Ray the Woodcutter says, hey there! I was down by the caves of Who yesterday. Is that where Tommy lives? A flock of cows nearly did me in. Watch out for them. I think those are like owls. Ken the Baker says, ack! Another loaf burnt to a crisp. It's all because Drax forced me out of the weapon selling business. Really? Drax the Destroyer? You have to let Star-Lord know about that. In fact, I can't even buy a rolling pin because Drax controls all the trade nowadays. That Drax, I'll tell you. Fergus Urquhart says, good to see you, Prince, but do you have to trample my crops? Yes, I do. I do. Little boy says, I want to serve under you when you're the new king. Goals? I mean, It's kind of sad. He's looking forward to who he's going to be a servant for. Poor kid. Mother says, are you preparing for your coronation? That's not my mother. Dealer Don. Oh boy. I think we just stepped into the Bronx. What's an honest man to do? There's no business in exile. I don't know. Dealer Don, he doesn't sound like such an honest businessman to me. So I think we talked to everybody. Yeah, I think so. Slimes. Yeah, let's go. Wait, Prince Logan. Elias told us you had to stay inside. Not again. And I guess I'll have to stay. That's strange. Why did he give up so easily today? I don't know. He usually argues. What's his problem? And now the game is taking over. Hey, Fergus. I was wondering about the secret passage. Yeah, Prince Sir. I finished it this morning. But I'm worried that we'll get in trouble if Elias finds out. Not to worry. I'll take care of Elias. Where is it? Just follow me. Here's the spot. Hang on a sec. It opens real easy. Go get those slimes. I'll close this up so Elias won't know. Thanks for your help, Fergus. See ya. Sure, anything for my friends. And now we're out. Oh god, we didn't even have to move. Okay, we got a slime already. Somehow I think that thing has a lot less than 75 hit points. So we get one experience and one gold. And apparently we don't even have to move. This didn't happen to me when I was testing the game in the beginning. As you can see, oh my god! Okay, stand by. Now we switch this back. And you'll see how the... It just appears. Okay, so you see it sounds a little different. And the music starts where it's left off. Wow, we're getting a lot of them. Now I know from experience we're not ready to go in there yet. Did I choose a name for the save? Choose file. See, if we go in, the Who Cave will die horribly. I'm not gonna use a torch, but there's a beastie right up here. These are the cowls? Yeah. Wait. I don't want to go back to town. I want to load. Wait, I almost had it. Oh, I actually survived. I'm probably not going to be able to run. Can I get to... Alright, let me try to run. Okay. You have to immediately run away from them. But I'm kind of messed up now, so let me just load this game. Okay. We need to just fight slimes for a little bit. So this is your standard grinding stuff. Do we have to grind to level 2? Not really. Logan escapes injury. But I'm going to. We're almost halfway there. There's nothing more dangerous in these little woods areas than there's just slimes out here that I've ever seen. You can actually go over there. Go like this. I thought that might attract them because it's continuous movement. Then you might be just stand where you are and they'll come to you. Halfway there. It's just boring to stand around. Kind of reminds me of Dragon Quest, Dragon Warrior, of course. I think you get them quicker if you just take small steps, maybe? I'm trying to figure out the formula for success. Or you can just stand there. So yeah, in the future I'm not really going to keep up grinding in. I mean, maybe a little bit. But from what I understand, there's not too much grinding to do in this game. I just want to see me get to level 2. Just something I kind of want. Let's check out that music. It's getting all jazzy now. Jeez, where'd they go? You know, I need 5 more. But I think I might be able to make the CD music a little louder. Because it is lower. It does seem a little lower than this music. And I'm playing this, of course, on an emulator. Which I forget the name of right now. But to configure the emulator, you have to enter everything into a config file. There's really very little to do with menus or setup or anything like that. You just edit the config file. And to play the game, you drag the game onto the program file in Windows. So it's weird. But hey, I figured it out. Come on, 3 more slimes. So I stop moving around. I seem to find them near the entrance a lot. Here we go. It knows. It knows that I want 2 more. Yep, there we go. I mean, the actual battle's really quick, which is good. It's streamlined, you know, it goes as fast as you want it to go. You can even have auto battle on. Okay, so we gained a bunch of stuff that went by really quick. Now, if we had auto off, it would just distribute these however the game sees fit, but... we'll put it there. Prince Logan, have you had your fun for the day? Elias caught us. I've taken care of Fergus. I doubt he'll be digging any more holes in the walls, Besides, I dread to think what your father would say. Okay. His father's dead, so it's kind of a messed up thing to say. And I'm sure that it would break your mother's heart if she knew what you were up to. So how about coming back to the manor and getting down to your studies? After all, there are only 2 more months till your coronation. Fine. If I have to... Your future depends on what you study. You must fulfill your royal destiny. Elias preaches on and on. Okay, Elias, I get the message. I will try harder. It's just that I miss my mom and think about my father all the time. I know this is hard for you, Prince, but soon you'll be seeing your mother, and maybe then you can learn of your father's death. But sleep now, because it's a hard day of study ahead of you. Tell me to go to sleep. So I guess we didn't study anything. Now the day's over. The royal maid says, it's time to sleep. I will help you retire. Wink. And how old is he? Sweet dreams, Prince.
Prince Logan, wake up.
We're under attack, my lord.
Uh-oh.
Monsters everywhere. There's not a moment to lose. Please arm yourself and follow me.
We got royal armor and plate and blade and stuff. Exciting.
This way, my lord. Through the secret passage.
Wait, what about you?
We're right behind you, my lord. Now hurry. There's no time to waste.
What's going on, Elias? Open the door.
I'm afraid we're a bit outnumbered, my lord. Though it's been some time since I've lifted a sword, I'm sure I can hold off a few of the beasties while you make good your escape.
Let me help.
You can, my lord, by not wasting another minute arguing with me. Go to Castle Sylvan. Send back reinforcements. We'll hold out until they arrive. Now go!
I'll be back, Elias. I'll be back.
Here come the beasties. Clonk, 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 clonk. The Who Cave. We automatically go right in. Alright, so we can use a torch. I have 3 of them. I thought I had 2. Well, now I have 2. So now we got the cowls. Now, we haven't really leveled up since... Well, we did, but we still don't have enough magic points, see that, to cast that cure spell? But our hit points are doubled, and now because what we have is this royal stuff, our attack and defense are way up from what they were. It's just, the music's awesome. Just listening for a second. Alright, cowls. Now they take just 1 hit point each. Can you imagine that? Unfortunately, we are only 1 person, so we only take 1 out around. So yeah, this really normally isn't the focus of my channel. I mean, I have played some JRPGs, such as the Lunar series and the Phantasy Star remakes, translations. Albert Odyssey, The Legend of Eldian, I played. Leveled up again. Alright, let's put 2 into strength, intelligence, speed, luck. Yes, I am sure. Dead end. That's the way out. Another flock of cowls. So yeah, I mostly play Western RPGs, but I do like JRPGs as well. And as RPGs go, including JRPGs, this is a rather short game, I've heard. So it's interesting because you got the random combats outside. And then inside the dungeon, you can see your enemy. Another level. amazing, isn't it? This is the... Yeah, this is the dead end. Alright, so we're going past the water. We got a chest with an herb. It's gotta be healing. Unfortunately, you don't get a description of your items. But we can see it's there. Hello. And then whenever we level up... Oh look, our torch star went out. Whenever we level up, our stuff, you know, our hit points and magic points are maxed out. Be nice if we get some offensive spells. We don't really have anything. So now we're out in the field. Just gotta wonder... What town is that there? Because that doesn't look like where Exile is. Sylvan! You! Stop! I haven't seen you before. Give me your name. I'm Prince Logan. I just came from the town of Exile. It's a slaughter, and we need help. I must see Baron Drax now. Prince Logan? Don't move an inch. We have orders about you. Uh-oh. If you value your life, you won't move from this spot. Sylvan Commander says, what a surprise! It's Prince Logan! Baron Drax is waiting to speak to you. You'll have to follow me to the throne room. It's a waste of time. We need your help now. That's too bad. Men, grab him. Oh, that's not going too well. What are you doing? Get your hands off me! It takes that many men to grab him. It's a lot of men.
My lord Drax, I bring you Prince Logan.
Ah, my dear prince. Welcome to Castle Sylvan.
Drax, what's the meaning of this?
I'm glad we were able to catch you before you wandered around the city. After all, you are one of the dearly departed.
Dearly departed?
Departed, expired, passed away, take your pick. The point is you were supposed to have perished when the monsters attacked Exile. At least that's what I've got the kingdom believing. What's more, since you're no longer with us, I've humbly offered to sacrifice my time and accept the crown in your place. Aside from the inconvenient fact that you're still alive, a situation that I will soon remedy.
All goes
according to plan. At least your father, the late King Corwin, had the sense to stay deceased when I arranged the last monster attack 10 years ago.
Oh boy.
Of course, it probably helped that I did the job myself, rather than leaving things in the hands of those clumsy monsters.
Okay.
Oh well. Please understand that it's nothing personal, but I would like to take you out of the picture once and for all. Unfortunately, securing my position as sovereign involves marriage with your mother, the lovely Queen Sylvia. To date, she hasn't agreed to my proposal.
Shocker.
If I throw your life into the deal, I'm sure she'll find me to be a worthy husband. So, for now, I offer you a pleasant night in our rat-infested dungeons. Take him away.
Alright, first of all, you talk too close to the mic. And wow, so he's the one who killed Prince Logan's father. I do not think Prince Logan knew that. Let me out of here. What the hell? Who's this?
Prince Logan, praise the seeker, you're still alive.
And who might you be?
Ethan, my lord. I'm a friend. I've come to free you.
Ethan?
Just lead me to Drax, and I'll put an end to his evil designs once and for all.
Out of the question, dear prince. He's too well guarded. Your first priority is to get out of here in one piece. Live to fight another day. Now follow me.
Click. Well, Logan says, wait, my weapons were taken, Ethan. Right. There may be trouble. Here. Alright, so we got a knife. And another thing. picked us gold. Well, I already have some gold. I have 140. You better get a move on, Prince. And remember, I'll always stand by you. Ethan joins the Prince. Okay. And gave us 400 gold. That's pretty nice. Alright, so now we can see the status of two people. This is us. And here's Ethan. Pretty decent. He has a short sword, a vest, and a buckler. Do we have any other, like, items from him joining? Oh, we can... There is more. Okay. I thought we'd limited to, like... What is that? 7 items. But no, we can scroll down. Good to know. So there's nothing we need to equip. There's nothing he needs to equip. Down and out for the count. Man, I can't let these people out. Those stairs down. Wait, Prince. Upstairs is crawling with sentries. I snuck in through a passage a bit further on. Let's get out there. Okay. That goes up. I would have thought that went down. Is this the passage we snuck through? Now notice we can't even get past this guy. Not that we need to. Keith the Cobra says, Ethan, what took you so long down there? It's a real honor, Prince Logan. My friends call me Keith the Cobra. All of us in the Resistance have been worried sick about you. For the moment, we're safe. But when Drax discovers that you've slipped his noose, he'll begin a manhunt for you. Ethan, get the Prince to Revere Village as fast as you can. Logan asks, Revere? Where's Revere? It's to the east. There you'll find Aaron. He leads us in the Resistance, and he served under King Corwin, your father. And don't worry, no one will recognize you because you've been gone so long. But I'm worried about Exile, Logan says. What's wrong, Prince? Ethan asks. I left my friend Elias there. He was in great peril. I hate to be the bearer of bad news, Keith says, but Exile was ransacked by Drax's beasts. Not a soul remains. The whole land's in peril. Logan says, Drax, his misery is going to be my mission in life. Ethan says, we've got to kick his darkness till it turns daylight. What? We've got to kick his darkness until it turns daylight. Okay. That's something to remember. Okay, the table was on top of the secret passage. Flee! Flee to Revere Village! We should fight! No! We should flee! What was the guy gonna say? You there! A prisoner escaped from the dungeons today, so if you see any strangers slinking around, give me a shout! Do I not seem like a stranger to you? Townsman says, we used to have a peaceful land back when King Corwin reigned. I miss the old days. Earl says, Drax acts like a sneak. I don't trust him at all. Old Bob says, it's a sad day for the land. Drax is king. And to think I've wasted all these years waiting for Prince Logan, Corwin's son. Who's that? Who's that Prince Logan? A young woman says, I heard on the grapevine that there's a Prince Logan impersonator skulking around town. I wonder who it could be. Huh. I guess we're not doing a very good job impersonating him. Stop! Entrance is forbidden. Today is the coronation. Okay. There's an old man here. old guy. Hail King Drax, may he reign forever. Oh, brother. Another dealer. Hi, glad to see you, but there's a holiday today. Lord Drax is being crowned, so we can't open up shop. Tell you the truth, I'm happy to see a crowning, because I don't have to work. But hey, loose lips sink ships, know what I mean? Here, accept this offer. Okay, he gave us a detoxin for free. Don't rat on me, eh? Okay, Great White North and all that. The armorer says, hey, what a great day! At last we have a new king! So the weapon shop is closed today. What about the armory? My apologies, but please return again. Another dealer. I'm not a happy man. This coronation thing has forced me to close shop for the day. It's a big downer because I've never had to close my shop for anyone, especially a grubby new ruler. Jason the Roamer says, I came to Sylvan Castle to meet with the sage, but a new king is being crowned and I can't enter. What if I return tomorrow? Same person. Is this the old guy? Yes. Empty. Empty. These are these two people. Hail King Drax! Long live the king! Ditto! I don't have any original thoughts. Okay, actually gonna call in an episode here, guys. We're gonna leave Sylvan, and we gotta go to somewhere else to the east. I forget already. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode, and always seek adventure.